Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Final Fantasy X. In the last episode, we fought Dark Yojimbo. And in this episode, I think we're actually going to go fight. We're going to quote unquote break the quote unquote order. It's not my fault Principal Please Do wants to hate me just because I drove her hatch back through the quote unquote open house. The quote, good lord, what an unbelievable. We're gonna go fight Dark Anima, because I fought her off screen and she really wasn't that bad. But it was also really interesting. Oh, hey, you know what else, actually? I think Machen has new dialogue. Hey, what's up, Machen?
Shall I teach you about the spirit of days long past, eh?
Eh? Sure, let's listen to it. How long is this gonna be?
There is a legend now.
A legend.
Just before the horrible sin.
The horrible.
A terrible war raged between Bavel and Zanarkand.
Yes, I'm familiar.
The armies of Bavel attacked Mount Gagazet.
Mount Gagazet.
Song echoing across the snowy slopes. Tis a song from an other world, they said. Soldiers panicked and ran. And then, as if to pursue the retreating armies, sin appeared.
Oh my god.
Scouts from the Vell braved the mountain. On the other side, they witnessed the ruins that had been Zanarkand. The city destroyed, not a single soul left standing. Gone.
Gone.
In its place, a multitude of the faith had gathered on Gagazet. They were singing a song. It's the song we now call the Hymn of the Faith.
Whoa.
That, as they say, is that.
Spooky.
Well, maybe not all of it.
Nice. Any more?
Would you like to hear the rest?
Hell yeah! Let's continue.
Rumors flew in Bavel about Sin's sudden appearance. They said that the people of Zanarkand became the Faith. That they...
Okay, I was wondering if they were going to make that connection.
And that the man responsible was none other than the summoner Yevon. Ruler of Zanarkand.
Here we go. He's explaining this.
Lord Father of Lady Unaleska. On the eve of Zanarkand's destruction, Lady Unaleska had fled to safety with her husband, Zaon. Later, the two used the final summoning to defeat Sin. Yet the people of Bavel still feared Yu Yevon. It was to quell his wrath that they revered him.
Quell his wrath! Scary voice.
So were born the temples of Yevon.
Mm.
I suppose it's possible Unaleska had planned it that way from the start. A fair trade. She defeats Sin in exchange for her Lord Father's honor. Of course, there's no proof. No, the facts are lost in the mists of time. And who'd admit Yevon was an enemy of Bavel? You can bet the temples had a hand in covering that one up. That, as they say, is that.
Oh, I was hoping there. I was hoping there would be more, because I was thinking we could do that. We could do that later. There's actually going to be a fun. There would have been a fun time to actually do that. So what we need to do here is we need to go to the cave entrance. In order to fight Dark Anima, first we have to make our way back here. To the Mount Gagazet Caverns, conveniently, literally, right here, next to... You know, I'm actually going to save my game. Well, maybe I won't. Maybe that's okay. You have to come back here to this area, this underwater area. And this is actually a good opportunity to show something. If we get into a fight here, there are those enemies called Mail Spikes, I believe it was. Come on, get into a fight. There we go. There's none here. This is all these guys. Hang on. Dang it. The mail spikes you can actually bribe for something very interesting. There's one. It's this big chonker. I believe you need 600,000. I'm just going to drop 600,000 because I have plenty of money. Mail spike, 600,000 gil. Huh? Huh? Hey, LMAO. Mail spike 600,000 gil, or maybe it's maybe like 400,000. I forget exactly how much. We'll get you attribute spheres. And actually, two of them. I didn't know it gave you two of them. Maybe that's like the other thing where like it can you know, it's like the amount you get from bribing varies. Maybe it just varied up to two, or maybe it was that because of the overkill. But attribute spheres are extremely valuable because they allow you to activate an attribute node already used by an ally. That means any node that increases stats, including luck. Now obviously that's important, because the only other way to get unlimited amounts of spheres to activate luck nodes is to defeat the Earth Eater. If you want to bribe mail spikes instead, you can do that. It's expensive, but it's easier, and you don't need to grind yourself up so high for it to, you know, be convenient to do. You know. So that is another option. If you don't want to fight the Earth Eater, you can bribe attribute spheres from the mail spikes to activate your luck nodes. But anyway, over here, you remember this puzzle we had to think, this thing we had to hit with Waka. The Summoner's Trial. If you would face me, you must first face my trial. Use Waka's ball to hit the center. It's like that thing in Mario Galaxy where the grumps were like, damn, son. What? That was nowhere near that shit, man! Jeez. See ya! Ah, dang, I didn't hit the note. See ya! Okay, let's try that again. I think the blue is gonna be in the way net this time. Yeah, what a bitch. That was totally lined up. I just threw it a little bit too early is all. Okay, now this should work. No, that thing is in the way. Fuck! That blue is in the way. That bouncing blue and that bibbity-bobbity. Jeez, Titus attacked so quickly that the camera didn't even have time to return to a neutral position. That's crazy. Alright, try again. Okay, now. Thank you. And with that, this scary cutscene plays where Dark Anima appears at the base of Mount Gagazette, off to the side. And she'll just stand there, and it's really off-putting, because you'll get back down there, and she'll just be there, and her chains stretch across the entire clearing, the entire little plaza, but she doesn't do anything unless you approach her. That's actually what I was talking about when I said, you know, there might be a good time to listen to that story from Machen. It's that, it would have been cool to listen to that story about the old time, about the ancient Spira before any of this crap with Sin happened and how Sin came to be. Incidentally, how the hell did he know all that? He said it was legends, I guess, but it would have been cool to listen to that spiel. With Dark Anima's chains here. Oh, Machen actually isn't even here. Okay, well, I guess it's a good thing that I listened to him there, then. This guy is still here. In fact, all the NPCs disappeared, except for this guy. Ronsal is prepared to fight. Let's keep weapons and armor in top shape. Oh, you sell weapons? Silent Strike, Zombie Touch, huh? Not too useful. Whatever. So here's Dark Anima. I'm gonna save, because I don't want to have to do that again. I'll make a new save, whatever. Isn't this scary? Like, God, it's just, Dark Anima's just there, and when you get close, and oh God, this camera angle, like, they couldn't possibly make you look any smaller next to this monstrosity. But yeah, just like the fact that the, and I don't think Anima, I don't think she ever goes away either. Man, you can see her all the way up there, looking like an almond. I don't think she goes away if you leave Mount Gagazette either. Does she? Let me see. Because if she does, I can just reload my save. Well, I'd have to pause the recording and quit out and then reload my save. It would be a huge pain in the ass, but it would be cool to see if she actually, does she stay if you leave the area? yeah, she's still there. Ooh, God, that's scary. Because you could just, like, walk up and down here. Anybody could walk up and down this path, and Dark Anima wouldn't do anything to them. But the chains are there, and they're constantly moving just as a reminder that she's still here. And, again, like, as you get close to her, that can't, this camera angle, ugh, it's freaky. Now, unfortunately, when you actually fight her, it's the regular boss, it's the regular battle theme. But there's that spooky shot. I don't know. It's that's also creepy. That's like the only time in the whole game there's like a unique shot like that entering battle. It shows that shot of Anima's eye, and then it freeze frames and fades into this screen. Now this fight, it is extremely important that everybody in the party has at the very least Stoneproof, if not Ribbon. Because Dark Anima's regular physical attack will petrify and shatter you instantly, regardless of whether it deals fatal damage. If you're not protected from stone, it will petrify you and it will shatter you instantly, no matter what. So everybody in the party has to be protected against that, or else she's going to whittle you down completely, and there's not going to be a damn thing you can do about it. Now, thankfully, I have three party members who for whom that is true. And other than that, Dark Anima really isn't that bad, actually. It's her regular attack, her strength is only 155. So if you're immune to the petrification, her basic attack is basically sucks. It can barely do anything. Now obviously her overdrive is still a problem. And she does have pain, which bypasses all instant death protection, so it will instantly kill you no matter what, which obviously sucks. But, you know, it's not really that big of a deal. The only thing you really need to worry about is you need to make sure that when her overdrive fills that you summon an Aeon or have auto life, because Oblivion will do about 97,000 total damage to everybody. So there's no surviving that. But other than that, you know, she has Mega Graviton, which deals 7/16 of everybody's max HP, not their current HP, so it can kill. And it does try to inflict a whole bunch of statuses, poison, silence, sleep for like 100 turns. But obviously we all have ribbons, so that's not gonna be a problem. We can pretty much just plug away at her and just heal when we get low and use auto life or summon an Aeon when she's about to use her biz. Also, worth noting is that Dark Anima, I'm not going to show it, but remember how the Omega Flan was totally immune to physical damage? Well, Dark Anima is totally immune to anything that isn't physical damage, and unlike the Omega Flan, unlike the Jumbo Flan, which we could hit with, like, overdrives, which didn't technically count as physical damage, they were like special damage or whatever, anything that isn't a physical attack, which can bypass Dark Anima's immunity to magic, she'll absorb and heal from. So, yeah, basically the only thing you can do is just attack, which is how you should be doing it anyway, because Quick Hit is like is objectively the most powerful thing in the game by a huge margin. Like, it's not even a competition, really. Well, you don't learn Daredevil. Wait, again? Didn't I? Oh, that was right. That was when I died. Of course. Okay. We could keep going. We're not really in any danger here. Cause now she's got an overdrive. So all I have to do now is make sure that when we get to our last three turns, at least one person has auto life on, and we'll be fine. We are gonna lose quite a bit of we are gonna take quite a bit of delay from dying, because you still take the delay even with auto life. It's basically no better than just having auto Phoenix, except that it works even if everybody dies at the same time. So we can just auto life everybody. Tidus is gonna have to spend 97 MP to do this, which sucks, but that's why we have Mega Elixirs. This is a good time to use them, you know. These are like the strongest enemies in the game. Did I mention that Dark Anima has 8 million HP? Yeah, she's got the third highest HP of anything in the game, I believe. I don't know. Dark Cindy. I don't know how much HP Dark Cindy has. I don't think it's 8 million, though, because Dark Cindy is part of a three-piece set, obviously. So, for all three of them to have that much HP, I know that Dark Mindy and Dark Sandy don't have that much HP. I actually managed to beat Dark Sandy. She wasn't so tough either. This is gonna hurt. Oh, yeah. And Dark Anima's Oblivion also deals MP damage. So, pretty much no matter what, you're gonna be left after this attack with very little. But we'll be fine because we all have auto life. And that only refills you. That only brings you back. Oh. Wait. Huh? Oh. Okay, Lulu came back with more HP because she has magic booster, I bet. That's probably what it is. That makes sense. Let's use a Mega Elixir, because obviously we can't do anything unless we have more MP, because we need to be able to use Quick Hit. Do I have Haste? I have Haste Iga. It's better to use a Chocobo Feather. It's got less delay. Bup. I wonder, actually, if Titus's overdrive would do any damage. There's the regular physical attack. It does inflict curse as well, but you're not going to be using your overdrives against these guys anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah, so as you can see, basically, as long as you can mitigate the things that Dark Anima has that really make her dangerous, namely the Petrification and Oblivion, she really doesn't have that much else she can do. She's kind of a weakling, just got a whole lot of HP. Da-da. I'm curious exactly how long this is going to take, because we're doing, you know, we're getting about 10 hits off every time. That's about a million HP of damage for every one of her turns. Mega Graviton. I don't care. That means nothing to me.
Ha! Ooh woo.
That stupid little Onion Knight walking along all happily. Okay, Yuna's gonna get another turn. I might have to summon an Aeon here. If I bring in Anima and actually, if I bring in Anima and then actually use Guard, I know they'll survive. Actually, you know what? As far as that goes, we have three turns. Let's just use auto life again. This Quick Hit really makes it hard to plan, like, who's gonna get the last turn before the boss. Man, Lulu has Holy. That would be weird to see. Okay. Auto life again. Whatever. Everything's fine. We'll use another Mega Elixir. It's no big deal. Oh, this animation sure does take forever, though. Man, Titus actually took two hits to kill there. Alright, yeah, we get it, okay. It's scary that we haven't even seen the summoner for this thing. I wonder if we're gonna see them in, like, the cutscene after the fight. I suppose if I wanted to, I could have Lulu cast all the auto lifes, but it really doesn't matter. We have to use a Mega Elixir after that anyway because of the whole, you know. Oh. Aw. That was because it was a crit. I thought she was about to get the killing blow there. Oh my god, okay, are we done? Yeah, look how... Are you kidding me? This is a Dark Aeon, and her attack did less than 2,000 damage. That's pathetic. Is her overdrive filling faster? I think I'm just imagining things. Ah? No. Dang it, Lulu, stop faking me out with those camera angles. My god! Okay, I'm gonna quickly check and see, just to make sure there's not anything else about this fight that I'm forgetting. Yeah, I'm not really seeing much, just tank and spank. Get your stats high enough and whatever. Your Bob's your uncle, basically. Oh, you know what? Lulu still isn't hasted. Hey! But that's fine. Ooh, is she gonna get an overdrive here? Ooh, I think she is. Unless I hold off here. If I go for these next two hits, she's gonna get an overdrive. And I would rather that not happen. Cheer! Hooray! So happy. Oh, stop doing that. Jeez. Yeah, it's pretty disappointing that these guys only have like Dark Anima and the Dark Maga sisters both use like the basic battle theme, so it's like whatever. Oh my god, would you die already? Jeez, this is like the most nothing fight, and you're just not dying. Alright, well, let's see. Maybe I can grant... Oh, I can't grant summon. Why can't I grant summon? Huh? Why can't I grant summon? Oh, man. I just thought of a funny quote from a VTuber. Isn't it supposed to be boings, thighs, and butt? Why armpit? She just says it so innocently and so simply. I don't know. Never mind. Here we go again! So why can't I use Grand Summon? That's a weird thing to not be able to do. Dark Aeon. Oh, I guess I should show the final battle too. After I fight the final boss, I should show the final battle, because when we fought the final battle in part 80, we were still missing some Aeons. So, you know, I don't want to miss those. I know why she couldn't use Grand Summon, because she was cursed. That's why. That makes sense. Okay, that's all it was. Yeah, because her regular physical attack inflicts curse, of course. No, you idiot! It's the girl. Oh, of course. God, that guy in Avatar, that guard who thinks the lemur is earthbending, when he gets corrected and he's like, "Oh, of course." Like, he grimaces, like, wider than anybody I've ever seen grimace in my life. Scary! Scary! Man, that would be a good thumbnail. Anyway, as you were. Are we almost done here? My god. Holy shit, dude, we get it already. Fucking, oh my God. Why do you have 8 million HP? You know, apparently, you know, there's like a challenge run with it for this game where you like try to beat the whole game without sphere leveling. And apparently there's only one person who's ever beaten Dark Anima in one of those runs. The last three super bosses, Shinryu, Nemesis, and the final one are actually considered to be fully impossible in those runs. I can't believe this bitch is not dead yet. This is unbelievable. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna cast Auto Life now. Because then I'll have a full turn. I'll have a full, like, 10 turns or whatever to do damage before she gets her overdrive off. Da-da-da-da. I should have been doing this the whole time, honestly. You know, get Auto Life up sooner than later before you start attacking. The pain, the toilet. Please die. Please die. Please die. I don't want to fight you anymore. I'm so done. Yurili, can you finish this bitch off? Like, seriously. I am so over this. Man, you know what I just realized? If this doesn't kill, I'm gonna have to watch this whole animation through 2 more times. Not that much of a... These guys look so stupid. It's like, look at these two clowns singing with one voice. And then you look so stupid, man. Exodia, obliterate! Oh, that's weird. Dark Anima's bottom half isn't visible. Even though, like, you know, she's, like, floating in the air. Hey, the pain of my dad. What the fuck is that? Seriously? Wow. Well, that's pretty lame sauce, dude. I'm not gonna lie. Was that even max? Was that even over 100,000? All right, here we go. I'm gonna go refill my water bottle, and maybe by the time I get back, this will be done. Yeah, I'm serious. After that animation ended. What do you say, Dark Anima? You want to give up the ghost sometime soon? I'm a busy man. Yeah, you're still. Titus is still hitting for max, so I don't even need to heal him. Banana. Holy fuck, would you die already? Ah! Ow. Alright, now we should heal him, because if we don't get the overkill, I'm going to be very sad. The overkill matters very much to me. Oh, I shouldn't have used Kiraga, because Kiraga has more delay than using an X potion. Holy crap, dude! Thank you! Finally! Jeez! Man, that took 30 minutes, too! Boy, howdy. Astral Sword, though. What's that? Oh, no. Wow, there's not even a cutscene? Wow. Okay. Nothing. Zilch. Noodle! Wow. One MP cost and Death Strike? That's pathetic. Heartbreaker.
I'm a Heartbreaker. I'm a Nimichurls.
Alright. Well, that's gonna do it for this episode, I think. Does Machin come back if we zone out and zone back in? Give me my Machin back. I want my Machin back, Machin back, Machin back, Machin back. This one Ronso is so brave standing here even as all hell breaks loose. There he is! Hey, buddy!
I'd like to hear more, would you?
Is there more?
Let me tell you about the hymn of faith.
There's more! Oh my gosh!
Hosanna comes on. Of course, the Evan clergy. Then, as these things often go, those who disliked hearing began to sing it. The Albed, for instance.
But those Albed use a forbidden machina.
Became the symbol.
You know what that means?
Against Yevon.
Sin was born because people used machina.
Capitulate. They lifted the ban on the song and spread a new story. They said the hymn was a song sung to soothe the souls of the dead. And so saying...
They shall serve me in the land of the dead.
That's why today, the hymn is sung all over...
Cool.
Spira.
I didn't know that.
You could say...
That those Anakin is gone. My God.
Ah, but look at the time. I've rambled on again. I do love stories, you see. Well, I owe you my gratitude.
Oh, is this it?
This old scholar out.
Oh, is that all?
Like to hear about this place once more?
No, that's all right. Never mind.
Suit yourself.
Hey, you said you were done, man. Don't make me feel bad. Well, oh, that was nice. We beat Dark Anima and heard a bunch of stories from Machin. Ah, how lovely. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Final Fantasy X. Next time, I think we should go take on the Dark Maga Sisters. Ooh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You can see me smiling as I go on him. Okay, stop being stupid. Bye.